In this screencast, we will explore the functions that are available in the sidebar. In the previous videos, we frequently used the sidebar to make adjustments to the individual blocks. But note that the sidebar actually has two tabs, Block and Document. So far, we used the Block tab, which was different for every block. Let us now look at the Document tab in the sidebar, which contains settings for the posts as a whole. The first tab is the status and visibility. And the first thing you can do here is determine the visibility of your post. You can set the visibility by clicking on the public link. It will open a flyout menu with the options public, private, and password protected. Determine the visibility by clicking on one of the options. And finish the action by clicking anywhere outside the menu. Second, you can choose when to publish the post, immediately, or schedule a different posting time and date. To pick a posting time and date, click on the link here. A flyout menu appears where you can insert the desired time and date. Once you have selected the date, simply close the menu by clicking anywhere outside of the menu. The stick to the top of the blog option allows for the selected post to appear first, even if you post other, newer content after publishing it. Note that if you select this, you will be able to preview the change only once you actually publish the post. So we'll select it now, and we will see how it will be displayed once the post is published. The pending review option will mark the post as pending instead of as draft. Note that if I select this option, the save link at the top changes from save draft to save as pending. The pending status will also appear in the post's overview, as you can see if I go to the post overview screen. If you have more users of your page, you will be able to choose who the author of the post is by clicking on this menu. The final option in the Status and Visibility tab allows you to delete the draft by clicking on the Move to Trash button. The next settings in the sidebar allow you to view your previous revisions. Click on it and a new screen will open. At the center of the screen, you see the before and after versions of the revision. To view when a revision was made and by whom, click and hold the arrows here while sliding the mouse left or right. You see the different changes appear at the breaking points of the slide bar. To restore a previous version, drag the arrow to the desired point and then click on the Restore This Revision button. Moving on in the sidebar, next comes the Permalink tab. In order to tell you about permalinks, I will also use the Categories tab here in the sidebar. If you remember, we already picked a basic URL structure for our posts, which was the site name, followed by the category, and then the post name. You see here that we have the basic structure set. Since we do not have any categories created, the post is in the uncategorized category. We will tell you more about the theory and practice of categories in the next module. For now, instead of leaving this post uncategorized, we can actually quickly create a category here in the sidebar. If you want to add a new category, simply click on the Add New Category link. Add the category name, and if necessary, assign a parent category. Then click the Add New Category button, and it's done. I will now select this category for the post and click Save. And you now see that the category is changed here in the permalink. As previously mentioned, the basic permalink structure, in this case, categories and post name, is something we will not change, since it may lead to errors. What we can change is the last part of the URL, which is the post title. The basic structure will stay the same. Of course, we will still have the countries followed by the post title. However, we can make changes to the post title itself. For example, if the title seems too long, we can shorten it by removing some of the words, like this. It is important to mention that once you publish the post with this particular URL, you should no longer change it. If you do change it, the post will be published on multiple pages, which will lead to errors and consequences for the findability of your post. Okay, now that we saw both permalinks and categories, we can move on to the next setting, tags. To add a tag, simply type it in the Add New Tag box. Note that you need to press the Enter button on your keyboard after each tag you add for it to be added. In the next setting in the sidebar, you can add a featured image to your post. Click on the Set Featured Image button. You can either upload a new photo or choose one from the media library. I will choose this one and click Select. You now see the image in the sidebar. To see what the image looks like in the post, I will click on Save and then Preview. And you see that the image is automatically set as a cover for this post. Moving on, in the sidebar, you can determine the content of the post excerpt. This refers to the excerpt that will be shown when your post appears in an RSS feed. And if your theme supports it, it can also appear in other places that allow quick summaries, for example, in the category archives. Finally, before publishing, in the sidebar, you can choose to allow or disable comments, or allow and disable pingbacks and trackbacks by leaving the box checked or unchecking it. If you are satisfied with everything here, it might be wise to first preview the post before publishing it. And once you are satisfied with what you see in the preview, you can move on and publish by simply clicking the Publish button. That will trigger a new menu in the sidebar where you can once again check the visibility and the time of publishing the post. At the bottom, you can choose to always see these checks or skip them in the future. All that is left now is to press Publish and the post will be live. Note that even though your post is now on your site, you can still make changes to it. You can continue editing as you did before, and instead of saving the draft, you will need to click Update. Alternatively, if you want to temporarily remove the post from your site, click on Switch to Draft, which will remove the post until you decide to publish it again. Let's publish it back again and preview it. And this is what the post will look like once I click to read it. And if I click on the Posts overview, I also see that it is featured and that the featured image appears as a cover image. There are a few more things to add concerning the sidebar. First, some plugins, for example, the Yoast plugin, may also appear in the sidebar. And of course, depending on the plugin, the options that will appear will differ. Secondly, so far we explored the sidebar in the post editing screen, but the sidebar also appears in the pages editing screen. Let's see it by clicking on the pages menu item and then click on a page. You see that the options are actually the same. You have the sidebar divided into the document and blog tabs. The blocks you can add to pages are the same as the ones for posts. The only difference is that in the document tab of the sidebar, there are slightly less options compared to the post. And there is one different option here at the bottom, which is the page attributes, where you can assign a parent page. We will tell you more about parent pages in the next module. So that is it about the sidebar. You are now ready to publish your first page or post.